Here we are. To below me is Becca Sanum. To my left is Clara Hannon. And they are the Mercer County Reinhardts Female Athletes of the Month for the month of February. And our first time we've had co-winners. I think it's only appropriate. Becca and Claire, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll ask you the same question, and I will start with Clara first. How is life without basketball?
It's definitely different. I miss it a lot. Right now, both of us are doing track right now, so it's a lot different. I miss basketball a lot, and I can't wait to play again.
Beck, how about you?
I don't think it's really hit me yet that I'm a senior and that was my last season playing in high school. If you ask me the same question next year around this time, I would definitely agree with Claire that I'll be missing it a lot. I mean, I miss it now, but next year I will definitely miss it even more.
Well, first off, before I go any further, Becca, now what's up with the eye? Everybody's seen this video. They're all asking the same question. What happened to your eye?
In the last playoff game, I don't quite remember the play exactly, but I'm pretty sure, shout out to Ackerman, she elbowed me in the eye, in my cheek area, and it swelled up pretty bad and got some nice bruising going on.
So losing in your final game to your rival wasn't enough, but then you get a black eye to take home with you. That's not very fair.
Yeah, but I'll definitely remember it, so.
Talking about remembering, Claire, what's your memories? Talk about a game or two that you will never forget.
Definitely junior year winning the D10 championship against Slippery Rock. That one's definitely up there. Sophomore year, our buzzer beater against Hickory. Also just beating Hickory was always fun. Freshman year, winning our first round playoff game, which was the first time. Well, it had been a really long time since Grove City had won a first round playoff game. So, yeah, those games, definitely never forget those ones.
Becca, how about you? I'm assuming some of those are the same for you.
Yeah, most definitely. But one of the most memorable moments my freshman year was when we played Meadville. And at the time, Meadville was a very good team. And Claire and I were just thrown into the fire being freshmen and everything and playing against some 18-year-old girls. And we were down by two, and with 2.2 seconds left on the clock, I get fouled and go to the line. So the pressure was on. And I made both free throws and sent us into overtime, and we ended up winning that game. So I think I'll remember that one for a very long time. But of course, the district game, winning that, and just playing these last 4 years was definitely very memorable.
How cool was it that you both got 1,000 points in the same season? I know it's not something you focus on. You're worried about the team winning. But Claire, you start just that the path to 1,000 and then getting it. Was there extra pressure? Did you feel that as you went into those last games or two before the milestone?
I didn't feel too much pressure. Maybe the game itself was, with a few points left to score, I got on a foul shot and I missed the first one. So, I guess there was a little pressure there. But, I wasn't putting too much pressure on myself to get it. But, yeah, it was super cool. Super cool experience, and it was even greater to get to experience that with Becca as well. It was a lot of fun.
Becca, now the fact that you did it and your mother never did, she was really close, and feel bad about that. That's something you kind of jab her a little bit, or is that something you don't really bring up too much?
Well, she ended up getting hurt, so I'm sure if she didn't get hurt and wasn't out a couple of games, then she probably would have hit that 1,000 point. And I think she told me that she didn't realize how close she was. And so if she would have known, she probably would have went to the hole a couple more times or something, As for me, going into the season, I knew that I was pretty close. So that was definitely on my radar, but it wasn't my main priority. And when I scored it, I needed 28 points going into the game. So that was definitely a lot. And it wasn't something that I thought I was going to do, because we were playing a team that I probably wouldn't have needed to be in the game the entire time. So I would have liked to had a home game, but luckily I had some teammates that passed me the ball a lot, and so I was able to accomplish that at a home game, which is definitely cool, so we could have some supporters and fans there watching.
Tell your mother that if I was tweeting back in her time, I'm sure she'd have been aware of her 1,000-point run. But
yeah, most definitely.
There was no Twitter back then. What's next? I know you both are doing track. I'm college in the works for both of you. Clara, you can go first.
Yeah, I'm going to Grove City College, so right in my backyard, and I'm going to be playing basketball there and majoring in exercise science.
And Beck, how about you?
I have not committed anywhere. I'm still searching for colleges, but I want to major in biomedical engineering, and I'd like to run track, so whatever the future holds, I guess.
Lastly, is it hard to believe that your high school careers are coming to an end? I mean, not just sports, but academically. I mean, in a blink of an eye, you probably started basketball back in third or fourth grade, and now it's pretty much over. Clara, your thought about that?
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, this year has gone by really, really fast, especially with the shutdowns and everything. And, you know, our basketball season ending, you know, makes you realize even more that, you know, you're a senior, soon track season will be over, and then I'll be done with high school academically as well. And it's pretty crazy. Time really does go by really fast.
Becca, how about you? Is it a little surreal that you're counting almost the days?
Yeah, it is crazy that it's already March. I mean, heck, in 2 more months, I'll be out of here. But to think that like my senior year would end like this, no one would have ever thought that. So I think with COVID and everything, it's definitely gone by way faster. It felt like just the other day I was a junior and here I am about to graduate. So it's definitely gone by way faster than I would thought.
Well, it was really nice to chat with you two young ladies tonight. It was only appropriate that our first co-winners were you two. You guys were intertwined for your whole careers, and I think it's very appropriate. So congratulations, Becca and Claire, on being named the Mercer County Rhine Arts Female Athletes of the Month.
Thank you.
Thank you.